The Prime Minister, Dr. Barnabas Sibusiso Dlamini, arrived in the country by road through the Ngwenya border post, where he was welcomed by cabinet ministers, principal secretaries and senior government officials. The Prime Minister briefed the media about his trip and the delegation he was leading, which included the Minister for Foreign Affairs and International Cooperation, Chief Mkwakwa Kametse. The Premier said they first attended the Non-Aligned Movement Summit in Venezuela. Dlamini says the summit started with the election of a chairperson, where the President of Venezuela, Nicolas Maduro, was elected. The Prime Minister says the theme of the meeting was peace, security and sovereignty, and emphasis was put on bringing peace in all member states of the non-aligned movement, security, and that the countries must enjoy their sovereignty instead of living in fear of some countries.
President of Venezuela, Maduro, lo kwaba nguye lo bambele umhlangano. Sicubulo ke sa umhlangano bekukuthula nephepha nemave kutsakati phathe angaphathanyiswa ekuphatheni kwawo. Peace, security and sovereignty. Bekungiletho tinzaba lebe tisetafuleni kakhulu. Kuletha kuthula kula mave onke ale non-aligned movement. Nekuphepha nekutsi ke emave akativa khululekile kutiphatha nangabe emave athukatanya kutsi bani utawutsini, bani utasisola, bani utasidumisa.
The Prime Minister says from Venezuela they proceeded to New York in the United States for the United Nations General Assembly, which was held under the theme Sustainable Development Goals, a universal push for transformation. The Premier says heads of state and government from all over the world addressed the summit, and for them as a delegation is to listen on behalf of the country and also represent or present His Majesty the King's speech. He says this year they were allocated 25 minutes to deliver the King's speech. Dlamini says on behalf of His Majesty, they congratulated the President of the United Nations General Assembly, who is elected every year. And this year, the President is from Fiji. And they also congratulated the Secretary General of the United Nations, Ban Ki-moon, who will be stepping down at the end of the year after serving two terms. In respect of the theme, the Prime Minister says it was upon the country to explain what it is doing regarding the Sustainable Development Goals, and that they explained to them one by one, taking from the National Development Strategy known as Vision 2022, which has eight thematic areas, being economic growth, education, health, agriculture and the environment, service delivery, infrastructure, governance and corruption, which the nation must know. He says in the speech they delivered on behalf of His Majesty, they combined the thematic areas of Vision 22 and the Sustainable Development Goals.
Umhlaba walalela ukuthi ngwenyama ithini livele Swatini lithini. Nawo ke lomhlangano uba nesiqubulo, uba ne theme. Ithemi yakhona ke be sustainable goals, sustainable development goals, ngapha ke sikhuluma nge universal push for a new framework yelive, transformation yemave, lokusho ukuthi le tifiso temhlaba wonke lotawenda ukuthi umhlaba uthuthuke ushintshe ube umhlaba lo wenetisa leto divele tlala ku sustainable development goals, a universal push for transformation bekuyi theme yakhona lebesikhulumele dukwayo kulesiqubulo ke kwasekuba ngumsebenzi welive ukuchaza ukuthi sendani seneswatini kulama sustainable development goals njengoba sesisuka kuma millennium development goals labeka ng 8 siphohlongo lama SDGs ang 18 so sawaqaphiya ke ngayinye 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 ikakhulu sisusela ku national development strategy yethu lesibida kalula sithi ng vision 2022 njengoba ke ma editors ma journalists athi kutsi vision 2022 unetindzaba leti siphohlongo letikhulunywako 8 thematic areas.
The Prime Minister says they also pleaded with the United Nations to include all nations in the General Assembly. But there are countries that are still not allowed to be members, such as the Republic of China and Taiwan. Further, the Prime Minister says they touched on the issue of the Security Council that the African continent must have permanent members as per the Ezulwini consensus. The Premier added that while in New York on the sidelines of the General Assembly, they met with the Secretary General of the Commonwealth and they discussed issues involving the kingdom. And they also participated in a business forum meeting between the United States of America and the African continent, which was attended by heads of state and government from Africa. And the meeting was addressed by President Barack Obama of the U.S. Reporting for Swazi TV News, I'm Sibusiso Dlamini at the Ngwenya Border Post.